Hello, welcome to Board Games with Niramas. I'm Joseph or Niramas, and well, Draco's holding the box, but I'm going to play solo Wingspan solo playthrough. This lovely game from Stonemaier Games, and let's just dive straight into the bird catching. We're going to try to not catch them, but sort of lure them into our habitats here. And we're going to do this solo, so I'll be playing against the Atoma. The Atoma over here has its own deck, it has its own goal. Yeah, it wants birds that can eat only rodents. It has these round cards that will be sort of determining how it goes in the race, because we are racing against the Atoma to get the most of something each round. There's these round goals, just like in the multiplayer game. We also have this card, which is a really smart design. So basically this will determine which row we're looking at when we look at the actions that the Atoma will take. You will see how that works soon. Everything else is set up. I have my board, I have my starting goals, my starting birds, my food, my cubes, of course, and here's some play rates as well that will help us out with the Atoma actions if I get confused and forget what they do. But it's fairly simple. Then we also have the lovely bird feeder over here, of course, ready and set. We have the cards out here. Draco looks ready to be an observer here, and let's get started. So first of all, I need to choose here. So I could be the forester, birds that can only live in forest, or birds that have at least one egg laid on them, the uligist, that's hard to say. So do I want to go for a lot of egg strategy or forest? Let's see what I have in my starting hand. I have the bear sparrow. He will lay an egg when he's activated. This guy will, okay. The killdeer, discard an egg to draw two cards. That's pretty good though. Draw two cards, wow. This is lay an egg on each of your birds with a sort of ground nest. I have a few of those actually. This is a predator. If there's any fish out there, gain a fish and put it on the card. He will eat some fish. So I don't have any here that can only live in forest. If we look out here, there's none of that as well. I think I'll go for the egg thingy. So I want to have birds with at least one egg on them at the end of the game to score points from my bonus card. And I have some egg things going on here. I think I'll get rid of this guy. I want this one, even though I want eggs, this is awesome. Discard one egg to draw two cards. And this one to lay eggs on the other ones here. So that could be a combo. I want to play him late though, so that I have a bunch of these ground birds nesting out, so that he will lay eggs on those. So I'll get rid of these two. And so if I'm going to keep three, let's see. Well, this is really expensive, but I'll save this for later, I think. And so I want to get these two out first, and so well, I would need a worm, a grain, and another, yeah, so I'm gonna pay the rodent, the berry, and the fish then. So I have to pay three because I'm keeping three cards. So that's the start, and I'm the first to act. You always act first, and then it's the Atoma's turn to do something. So let's see, what will I do on my first turn? I'm going to play one. And I guess it's this one because, yeah. So this needs both the grain and the worm. I know it's not called worm, but I can't pronounce the... I'm a Swede, so I can't pronounce the English word. It's like ver something, I don't know. So I'm placing the cube there, doing my action. And where do I place him? Well, I have to place him here, right? Okay. So that's my action. This goes over here to indicate I've done it. And now it is the Atoma's turn. So let's turn the camera over here and take a look, because we draw the top card, then we place it like this, and then we can see that they will do the top row action here because we're in round one. Really nice system here. And so they will do the draw cards. Basically what happens is we discard all three bird cards from the tray, and then the Atoma draws one and keep it face down. And when he keeps it face down, it's worth 3, 4, or 5 points depending on the difficulty level. I'm thinking that we're playing on normal, so this is 4 points for the Atoma at the end of the game. And then we will refill here, of course. So there will be a lot of rotation on the tray here when you're playing solo. Also, two of these when played guys are out. Draw two new bonus cards. Yeah, they both are draw two new bonus cards and keep one. I would like one of those. Huh. That's interesting. And this is the owl here. Look at the top card from the deck. Yeah, he will eat it if it's small enough. Okay. So it's my turn again. And I kinda need food, right? Because I could use this one to draw cards. So then I don't need to focus as much on the draw cards place. But this, yeah, I need some food. I need a green or a worm or a slug, maybe it's called. I'm not sure. So I'm going to do the, this is kind of boring to do it like this, but I only get to draw one of these dice and get that food. And I think I'll just take the worm. I'm gonna keep calling the worms just because I started doing it. So I'll take that one, and that's my whole action. Now it is the Atoma. So let's see what he will be doing. And he will do... Oh, this is interesting. Oh, by the way, I did forget something. Sorry, it's easy to forget things when you film. He did do the draw card, but he also adds a cube to the current goal. The goal of this round is to have eggs on birds in the waterlands. So now he starts out, he's considered to already have one. Now he got one more, so now he has two for the goal of the race of having the most. Anyhow, that was his first action, sorry I forgot that. Now it's his second action, he will take some food, and he will take it in priority order, as you can see from left to right, and he wants that double die, so he's going to take one of these, and he doesn't get any food, he just removes it. Then he will also activate all the pink powers that I might have. Just like if another player did something that will activate my pink power out of turn. Sadly, I don't have any now, but that's also, he will do this a bunch, I think. So maybe I should focus on getting some of those as well. That would be good. So it's my turn again. Now I have the food I need. Now I'm gonna play this guy. And since we have the goal of having eggs right on in the waterlands, I will put him in the waterlands. So I'll do the action of playing a bird, and I'll pay the little worm guy. I'll put him down here, and at the same time, I would like him here. So I will do the bet, but then I need an egg to do that, so I can't do that anyway. So he's down here, and that was my action. Now it's time for the Atoma once again. So it moves really fast like this. I like this kind of Atoma. They're just quick and easy. And so let's see. Oh, he will get an egg. That's everything that happens. That was quick and simple. And his eggs are just a point at the end of the game. So he has 1 point there. So it's my turn. And let's see. Now I want to get some eggs, right? Because then I can do this and draw cards. I have a sort of engine going here. So I will put my cube here. That gives me two eggs. I don't have any food though, so I could get the third egg. I'm not gonna get food before. So I'll get two eggs. And I will place them on this guy, because remember, we won't have eggs on water birch. So now I have two, and he has two, so we're tied there. Then I will activate this, which is to lay an egg on a bird. So let's do a third one. He can hold three, this killdeer down here. And so I'm in the lead, 3-2. Okay, so it's the Atoma once again. And he will do the other sort of draw a card. Well, basically he will take a bird. And now since his goal is to get birds that can only eat rodents, he will take this one. So it's 3 points to him. And that's all that happens. He never does anything with the sort of actions and so on, which is also something I like. He's really just straightforward. And we will refill here like that. If there would have been more than one, then he would have taken the one with the highest points on it. So that was his action. Now it's my turn again. And now I'm thinking, yeah, now I'll do this. I'll go down here. I get to draw a card. If I spend an egg, I can draw a second card. So I am going to spend an egg. to draw two cards. Wait, do I want to draw one? Yeah, I want to draw one of these. For some reason, I just keep going for the stack of cards, but I can take one of these. I think I want... Wow, they're so expensive, though. Three food items for these. But I mean, this one is 8 points. And this is nice, because he is a wild habitat. So, yeah, that would be nice. I mean, if we look at the goals later on here, I'm going to want to have birds in the forest, which I don't have. I want to have... the ground birds with eggs on them, that I will have that because that's building up. And this is having the little hole thingy nesting birds with eggs on them. That's a little later, but maybe he could serve that. He can only have one egg on him though. I think I'll take this one. So that's my first one. Then I take a second one from the stack here. Let's see. Well, that's good. It's on the ground, which I like. Okay, and it's in the water as well. That's good. Okay, so that was it. Now we will... No, we will refill at the end of my turn, right? Yeah, because then I will actually activate this as well, where I discard an egg to draw two cards. So now I'll just draw two blind here. I got the barn owl. This one. This is pretty good, and this is nice, like when activated all players gain a worm, then it's only me that gets it, he doesn't get these activation things. So that's interesting. I do want to play a bunch of these, but yeah, that's a lot of food I need. So anyway, that was my action. Now we go to the atom. Oh, we should refill here actually as well. There we go. So let's see what he is gonna do. He will... Okay, well, he will get an egg, and he will add a cube up here. So now he has three in terms of the goal. So he has three and I have one. We have to work on that. Then it is my turn. Okay, so if I'm planning here to do one of these, then which one would I... What's most important to get here fast? I guess... this is interesting. I get to draw a card when I activate this because I will always be the player with the fewest water birch. And it is the right type of... Yeah, this would be nice to get out. But then I need fish and something else. The problem is right now I have it so bad. I'm so bad at generating food. I need one card here so I can do this and discard a card because I can get cards down here and then I can discard there, get two food. Okay, so that's the plan. So then I'm going for the barn owl because he's the only guy that I can place in the forest. And he can... he can eat some rodents. Okay. So then I need two rodents. Wow, this is going to take a while because there's no rodents out there. There's no rodents on the bird feeder. Wow, this game is so rough, especially in the beginning because before you get your engine going well. So should I... Yeah, I have to get that food. Or I could draw more cards and hope that I get something else. That's an option as well. Because if I do this, I can draw three cards in total. I can just hope that I get some forest bird that is easier to play, that only takes one food. I'm going to gamble for that. So I'll go here. I'll draw just one card. I'm going random now because all the guys out here, they just want to believe in the waterlands. Oh, this guy can live in the forest, but once again, he needs two rodents. Then I go here, I activate this, I remove an egg to get two more cards. And here's a pink power. What is this? When another player takes the lay eggs action, this bird lays one egg on another bird with a bowl nest. Oh, I don't really have any bowl nests. Because this would activate if the Atoma activates the pink powers. I'm not getting lucky on these card draws. I'm not getting the proper card birds that can live in the forest. I only have two here. And they both... I would like to get... Well, the owl is better. This guy will just eat stuff. I think the owl is more interesting. He can hold more eggs than the hawk as well. So, okay, I'm back to where I was. I need... Well, I have a bunch of cards, though, which is good. So as soon as I get this going, I can start always getting... double food there. So it's the Atoma's turn. Let's see what he will do. Okay, he will draw a bird. There's no birds out here that that only wants to eat rodents. So then instead he will take one of these face down, and that's 4 more points for him. Okay, so my turn. I'm starting to realize that I think I should chase after the points goal here to beat the Atom. I think that's the way to go. He's up to 3. I could beat that by doing this, getting 2 eggs that I put on this guy. And then here I get to lay an egg on a bird, and then I put the 3rd. Well, then we tie, but that's better than losing at least. So we're 3-3 now on having eggs on water birds. Okay, so then it's the Atoma's turn. And he will get some food and activate pink power, so don't have that. He will start with rodents. There's no rodents. Then he will take fish, so a fish is gone. Okay. That's actually kind of good for me to get some movement in that bird feeder. So my last action, I can't put more than 3 eggs on this guy. Otherwise I would have done it, because then I would be able to beat him. So do I want to put 2 eggs on this guy instead? No, I have to. I think I have to get some food, even though. What food would I get though? Well, now the fish is gone as well. You know what? As crazy it might sound, I'm gonna do this again. No, because then I will have to spend an egg. Yeah. Okay, let's do this again then. Build up on some eggs. It's always good to have eggs for later on, right? And it's points. It's a point per egg if I keep them there. So I get 2. I'll place them on this. And then I activate him. He will lay an egg, but there's no bird that can hold. So that is it for me. And then we have the Atoma's last action, which will be... Oh, this is the one removed after round 1. So this card will go away after round. He will take some food and he will go for rodents. There's no rodents. There's berries. No berries. He will take this one. And that's actually good, because now there's only 1 die in there, so I can reroll when I grab some food. That's awesome, actually. So that was it. Now we go to the end of the round, and we'll take a look here. He has 3, basically, in the goal. I have 3, so we will tie for first place here on the first objective. And I'm going to show you that as well with the camera, sorry. So we will tie up here for the first place. My cubes comes back. Well, I lost 1, so you know, you get fewer actions as the game goes on. And then we will do some Atoma fixing here. So what happens is, well, this card will be flipped over. So we go to, you can see it's very clear. It's around 2 down here. And now his goal, this goal will be to have birds in the forest. And then you look at this section where it is birds in something. And then he's considered to have 1 already. And then we will try to build on that by just, well, he's not going to place any birds in the forest, but he will do it with his action cards. Then we take the action cards, we remove the one that says remove after round 1, so that's gone. Then we take the other ones and we shuffle them, and we flip this card upside down, so now we have round 2. Then we will go, we will use the same cards. It's a really smart system. We use the same cards, but you look at different rows, and that's how you determine the action of the Atoma. I think this Atoma system is really nice. The Atoma Factory has done great things before. I like it in both viticulture and Gaia Project, especially. The one in Sight, I'm not that big of a fan of. But anyhow, now we're done with the setup things. They will also get rid of these birds, as usual, and refill between rounds. And we'll start round 2. So this is when played, draw 2 cards. When activated, draw 2 cards. If you do, discard 1 card from your hand at the end of your turn. And this is what. Where's all the forest birds? I shuffled like crazy, but I only get these water guys. Well, he can live in the forest, the duck. Okay, so that's it. Let's do round 2. So, I'm first to act, as normal. And now I think I will get some food then. It's just a boring action to just do this like that, but okay. And now, since there's only 1 type of food left in the bird feeder, I get to reroll everything. So let's do that. And hope for some... Well, that's a fish. Okay, so fish... No rodent! Where's the... Come on, game! Where's the rodents? I need it for the owl and for the hawk. There's a lot of fish. I could go for... Well, this guy's just going to get me another bonus card. I mean, that's good, but it's not going to help me engine. This guy could help me to draw more cards. But then again, I'm not looking to draw cards. I have a bunch of cards. I want more food, so I want to place something up in the forest, but I can't find anything. Okay, it's a Thomas turn. And here we go. He will get another one of these face down for more points. Then it is my turn, and now I'm gonna do this again, I guess, to because now the goal is to have birch in the forest. I need to find a bunch of forest birch so I can get some food engine going as well. So I'll do this action, and I'm gonna give up an egg to draw two cards. I'm gonna draw blind because these guys out here are not really my Okay, two forest birch. I'm excited. The mountain chickadee. He can live in the forest, and he's cheap to put out as well. When activated, I gain a green from the supply and cash. Yeah, he's going to eat some green. The indigo bunting, he's kind of expensive, but when activated, gain a worm or a berry from the bird feeder. Yeah, that's good as well. Okay, so both were good. And then I move here, I remove an egg, and do this to draw two cards. Let's get even more. Yeah, even more. These can live in the forest. Oh, wow. So now I have the American Robin. Take a card from your hand behind. Tuck a card from your hand behind this. If you do draw a card, that's good. And lay an egg on this bird is good as well. They're both cheap to get out. Wow, now I have a bunch of options here. Now I have options. Okay. So these three I will probably play. I have so many birds, so yeah. Crazy. Okay, so that was my action. I did draw bird cards, and now it is time for the Atoma again. Let's see what he will do. And he will get two eggs. Oops, sorry for that. He will get two eggs, and he will remove a cube. If he already had put a cube on the gold for the round, he would remove one now, but he didn't put any there, so it doesn't matter. That's sad to miss that. Okay, so it's my turn, and now I'm going to grab some food, because now I can do... I'm going to do the little... mountain chickadee next, so I need some. I can do some green, so I'll do this, and I'll take the green. Then it is the Atoma once again, and he will take some food. He will take rodent, then fish. Okay, so he will take. Oh, and he removes all the dice of the same kind. I think I forgot this in the first round. He removes all the dice that matches that food token, so he takes all those three. Did I do that wrong? Yeah, I think I did it wrong in the first, sorry. Okay, so, and then he will activate pink powers. There's no pink powers, so it's my turn again. And I will... Now I will play a bird up here. So I'll play this mountain chickadee. He can live in the forest. Only in the forest, actually. He needs some green to be come here and be happy. And that's it. And now I can start getting a lot of food. So now it is time for the Atoma once again. He is going to get an egg and put a cube. Oh, these came in the wrong order. Would be better if it came earlier, then he would have removed the gap. So he's now up to two birds in the forest. I have one in the forest now, so it's 2-1. Okay, but I'm planning to play a bunch of these out here because I do have the eggs needed and so on. So now I think I will, now I will get food. And I will also give up a card. I'm going to give up this one, because that power is not really going to do me much. So that means I can draw two food, and... Yeah, I can get this one. That's okay. The worm. And then we reroll everything. And a lot of fish. And do I want... Yeah, I'm gonna take the berry. Okay. So nice, now I got two food. From just one action. I like that. Then we have this guy. He is going to... let's see. He's going to... once again, he gets a four-pointer card and he puts a cube. So now he's considered to have three birds in the forest. Wow. It's going to be hard to beat him. And that's done by... No. When I did this, I should have also activated this guy. Yeah, but there was no green. Oh, yeah. Okay. So then he couldn't eat the green anyway. Sorry, I need to calm down and focus on the game. So, it's my turn again, and now I'm going to play the chipping sparrow up here, which means I'm doing this action, which means I'm gonna have to pay an egg. And then he's active, and now when activated, I will lay an egg on any bird, so that's good. And also now when I do the food action, I will get 2 food and then activate these guys also. So that's good. Okay. So that was my action. Now it is the Thomas. And it's going to be hard to beat him. I realized that on the forest. So, oh wow, especially since he's going to put another cube there. Now he's going to draw a bird. There's no birds that will only eat rodents. So he will take one face down instead, right? If I'm not mistaken. Yeah, if none match, he will draw one card and keep it face down, yeah. And then he will also put a cube here. So now he has 4 birds in the forest. I can't beat that, obviously, as you see. I mean, then I would need to place all. That's not going to happen, okay. So since I'm not going to win that race anyhow, which is a bit sad, but I needed to pay the worm for this guy as well, right? I keep forgetting stuff. Okay, so that's not going to happen anyway. But I do want to have a great... Yeah, I want to have a great food engine going. So let's do like a plan. Let's do the American Robin as well. So I'm doing this action. I have to pay an egg to put a guy here. And he wants to eat some berries. So now when I activate the food action, I will get... Well, I have a bunch of cards to discard. So I will have 3 food. I'll activate all 3 of these guys. It's going to be awesome. that's nice. So now it's the Atoma. And he will get 2 more eggs. Well, yeah, now he has 5 birds in the forest. So, yeah, congratulations. There's no way I can beat that. I couldn't beat 4 even. And he has a bunch of more eggs. Wow, he's getting lucky with the draws. So it's my turn. And let's see. I think I'll get food. And then in the next round, I can start playing some birds. I think I'll do that, actually. Yeah, so I'll do this action, and I discard a card. Yeah, I'm gonna discard this water guy here. But next round, the goal is to have birds with the ground thingy, whatever it's called. Nesting, the ground nesting with eggs on them. And I have 2, and I can get some more out there, I hope, so... I'll probably get this guy out the next turn, so yeah, I'll lay an egg on each of those. That's nice. Okay. So now I get 3 food. So 3 food, I think I will do it like this, because... I really would like to get some rodents. I do want fish as well, though. Oh, I need grain, rodents, and worms. So I'll take this one. That's 1. And then they're all the same face, so I can reroll everything. So for 2... Ah, come here. For 2, and no rodents. For 2, I'll take these 2 grain, and 2 and 3. Okay. Then it is activation time. So when activated, take a card from your hand and tuck it behind there. And I'm going to take, I'm not going to play both of these. Yeah, so I'm going to take this hawk and put here. And if I do, I get to draw a card. And then I think I will take... Yeah. I'm going to take a blind card. Oh, it's this pink action. When another player takes the lay eggs action, this bird lays an egg on another bird with... Oh, that's kind of good. I guess. And he's really cheap to get out as well. Okay, that's pretty good. Then I go here. Lay an egg on any bird. So let's just get one here. And then... Oh, I should have planned for this. Now there's no grain. Oh, I'm stupid. Should have saved a grain. Okay, you know what, I'm going to cheat a little bit. So let's say that I kept 1 grain here, which would, and I don't take this grain. Instead, I would have taken, let's say, this worm. And now when we come there, we can take the grain. No, I'm stupid again. It doesn't say that it's a die. It just says take 1 grain from the supply. Wow, okay. Maybe he should have had one. Yeah, he should have had one earlier there. I'm just going to get one more. That's a point. Yeah, it's from the supply, it's not from the bird feeder. Wow, there's gonna be some issues with this playthrough, obviously, like most playthroughs. I do miss stuff, I'm sorry, but I'm trying to explain them as I go. And now I'm done with my action, and Automa will have one last action. So, the Automa will get some food, and he wants... Yeah, he's gonna take this guy, first of all. And then he will activate pink powers, there's no pink powers, and that's the end of round two. So, first of all, the goal, well, he has five birds in the forest, so congratulations. That's all we can say. And he's in first place. I have three, so I'm in second place there. Okay. And I get my cubes back, and we refill these cards. And then we're going to do the Automa setup thing as well. And let's see, is there anything interesting out here? This guy can move around when you activate him. If he's to the right, if this bird's to the right of all other birds, I have to move it to another habitat. Yeah, so he can move. It's interesting. Okay, so that's it. Let's do this thing where we will remove this card. So now we have round three card. Then the goal now will be to have, let's see, it's this one. To have eggs on the ground nesting, and he's considered to have five already. Wow. How am I supposed to beat that? I don't know. Then we need to find the card that says remove after round two. It's this one, so that's gone. And then we shuffle the rest, and we are ready for round three. Okay, so. What's my first action? Well, I have some food now. I guess I should play. Should play some birds, right? So. I don't have the rodents. I have everything I need for this one. So I think I'll just play it. Okay. So I'm playing this one, which means that I go up here. I have to pay an egg because it's in this column. He has to be here, so I'll place him down here. And he has a... I have to pay two green and a worm. And his ability is when played, lay an egg on each bird that has this grounding nest. I get to go for himself as well then. And this guy. And this guy. I could have planned this better, I guess. So I would have gotten more eggs, but... Anyhow, that's done. So now it is the Automa's turn. He will get two eggs, and once again he will remove... Wow, I'm getting these in the wrong order, because now he will remove a cube, but he doesn't have a cube there, so... Oh, so sad. I'm not getting lucky here. And then we have... My action will be to get a bunch of food, I guess. So here I will get two. I discard a card, so I get three. Yeah, this guy's way too expensive, I think. I will get rid of him. So I will get three food, and let's see, I do need, well, I would like rodents, or I could get some, yeah, I could get a berry, actually. I'll take the berry, and then I will reroll, because there's only one die face left, so now I take two more. Oh, there's the rodent, let's get that guy. And then let's also get this one, and I will take the slug, or the worm guy, there. Then I will activate here, we will keep going. So I can tuck a card, and then I get to draw a card. I am going to tuck this... I'm going to tuck this one, I think, because I'm not going to play that, I don't think. No, I'm going to tuck that under there, that's a point, and I get to draw a card. And yeah, this is pretty good. When activated, tuck a card from your hand. If you do, gain a berry. Oh, this, I want to get this guy out. Interesting. Okay, then we go here, lay an egg on a bird. I don't know, just put it here. Then we go here and put a grain on this guy. So that's a point. And so we're done. Now it's the Automa. And he will... Oh, I forgot something. So easy to forget things when you do film and play at the same time. We should be in round three. So we should have flipped this card and have it at round three. And he should have drawn a card the first time, not gotten two eggs. He should have drawn a card. So he got 4 points instead of two. And now he will do this. He will take food and he will start with the fish. So he takes the fish and activate pink powers. There's no pink powers. That's kind of sad. I should have those. Yeah. Okay, so now it's my turn again. I was planning on just doing another food run, I think, because then I can start playing cards. I'll just do another food action. So two, I want to discard a card to I'm gonna get rid of this guy then, because yeah. And then I get to draw three food. And remember, I do need more berries for this guy. I need rodent and more worms. So berries, worms, and rodent. I'll take the berry. And then I would reroll. Because there's only one die face left. This is a bit tricky when I'm so far away. Come on. And then I will take these two, I guess. So berry and a worm. So now I'm pretty. I have a lot of food now. Stuck up on food here. I wish I could get another rodent though. But you can always use two food as a wild card as well if need be. Then we will activate as usual. We'll go here. We'll tuck a bird. And now I'm not sure. But I wanna play this guy. I was planning to play this guy, but then again, if I never find that second rodent. I definitely want to play this guy because he will keep getting me more worms. And this is fun. This is three fish out. Okay, let's get rid of this guy then because he's a wild habit. Ugh. So good. Let's get rid of the owl. Why do I keep the owl? I don't know. No. It's going to be tucked. That's the whole thing. Tuck it under. Draw another card. Okay. Oh, an eagle instead. Oh, when you play, you get all the fish that are in the bird feeder if you play him at the proper time. That would be nice. But he costs two fish and a rodent. He's 9 points, though. Then we go here. We lay a egg. Let's just do that. And then this guy will get another green. He's really good. He's going to build up some points there. Then it is the Atoma's turn. And the Atoma will get a bird. There's no birds out that would only eat rodents, so he'll take a face down card instead. That's 4 more points, and he will add a cube, so now he's considered to have 6 eggs for the goal. Wow, that's gonna be hard to beat. Those goals are really tough. okay, so it's my turn. Now I can play some birds. I think I want this one, so I'll let's see, I'm gonna have to go here, which costs an egg. I don't want to take eggs from these three, because those are for the goal. It also costs a berry, 2 slugs, and he goes there. That's pretty good. I should remove the cubes, by the way. So I'm building up here, and then it is the Atoma, and he is going to get some food. He wants berries or fish, so he will take the fish like that, and he activates pink powers. There's no pink powers. It's my turn. Okay, so I am going to do this this over here. I'm going to play a bird again. It cost me 2 eggs this time, but it's okay. I'm gonna get that back later on, and I'm gonna play this cedar waxwing down here, and that cost me 2 berries, which I have. And now this action is going to be awesome when I do it, because I'm going to get 4 eggs plus all the other fun stuff. So that was my action. Now we go to the Atoma, and he is going to get 3 eggs and remove the cube, okay? So basically what this means is now he's considered to have 5 there, and I have, what is it? I have 3, right? I have 3 birds with a with a no, I need an 8 egg on this guy, but then I have will have 3 birds with an egg on it. So, wow, that goal is so hard. Oh, because it's not the individual eggs, it's birds with eggs on them. Okay, so then it is my turn, and now I'm gonna do the egg action to get 4 eggs. And I will put on here, 1, 2, I don't know, 3, 4. Then I will activate this, tuck a card here, and if I do, I gain a berry. And tucking card is like, I mean, that's a point. So then I get a berry from the supply. Then this is all players gain a worm from the supply. This doesn't happen, and this happens, lay an egg on any bird. Let's put an egg down here on this guy. So that's looking pretty good. And that's my last action. And then now the Thomas last action will be to get 2 eggs and a cube up here, which doesn't really matter because he's winning that anyhow. So now we'll do the scoring. So the Atoma is considered to have, well, it's actually here. He's considered to have 6 birds with eggs. I only have 3 with the proper, they have to be on the ground habitat. So once again, the Atoma wins there. In the last one, we want to have eggs on birds with that symbol. That and I only have 1 of those, so I'm going to lose. Then I get my cubes back, which is only 5 now for the last round. We remove the cards. Get 3 new ones out here. And then let's see the Atoma fixing. Let's not forget anything now. So we need to find the card that says remove after round 3. It's this one. It's gone. The other ones are shuffled. And this is turned upside down. So now it's round 4. And we should also do this thing here with flipping this card so that it is round 4. And now in round 4, we're going to have that goal. And he's considered to have 7. Are you kidding me? How am I supposed to battle that? Wow, that is just crazy. Okay. Well, okay. So I'm not going to win that. I mean, I can't even put 7. I have to put 6. Yeah, there's no way. Okay, so let's get started. My first action. I only have 1 card, so I need to draw cards. So I think the first action might be to just go and do that. I do want this one, new bonus cards, but then I need fish. So yeah, let's do this, and let's get rid of this card, actually. No, let's get rid of an egg. I'm stupid. An egg to draw 2 cards. Okay. Do I want any one of those that are out there? Well, that's kind of good. That's expensive to play, but... Yeah. I kind of want this one, I think, because... This, I can pay for it. It can live in the forest. And when it's activated, repeat a brown power on another bird in this habitat, which means I could do any of these. I could, yeah, that would be good. Okay, so I take that. Then my second will be a wild card here. Play a second bird in your, oh, well, that's not good now because it's already full down there, basically. Okay, so that was 2 cards. And then we go here. I discard an egg to draw 2 cards. And then we will refill as well. And the ones I got now was... Yeah, this is play a second bird. Those, I'm just gonna use these to tuck under things. And this is discard a fish to tuck 2 cards from the deck behind this deck. This bird, but I'm not gonna have that much fish. So I guess I will try to get these 2 out, because this could be really nice to draw 2 new bonus cards and keep 1. That just gives me more points, basically. And this is fun, so... I'll play a bird next turn. But that was my action to draw bird cards. Now it is the Atoma. So let's see what he will do. He will get one of those 4 pointers. And he will put a cube. And where it, well, it's up here. So now he has 8 cards with eggs on them, which is crazy. That is my turn. Now I'll play this Northern Mockingbird. Up there. It costs 2 eggs. And a worm and a berry, and that was my action. It's the Atoma. He'll get 3 eggs. I'm so behind on points here, I think. And he also puts a cube there, which, yeah, doesn't matter. I'm not gonna win that. But I do want to have an egg on this guy at least, so I will be in second place. Because if I don't have any eggs or any requirements filled, then I'm not in, even in second place. So that's important. Okay, now I'll do the food thingy. So I get 3 food. And let's see. Well, now I need fish because I want to get this guy out. There's no fish there. So I guess I'll just take a grain. And then I reroll the last one. And I have 2 more to collect. And no fish at all. Wow, I'm so unlucky here. No fish at all. Wow. So what do I want then? You know what, I'm just gonna take these 2 and I'm gonna take 2 worms. I think I will have to trade these to get the fish or something. And then we'll start activating. So now this will copy a power of another bird here. So I guess I will do 2, I will put 2 grains on this guy instead of 1. We copy that. This will lay in, I should do them in order. This to tuck a card, and then I will draw a card. So I get rid of one of these that I don't really need. They are just basically building up here faster, but I'm already built up there. So I get to draw a card. And yeah, I'll take a wild one. It's not what I wanted. And then here we get to place an egg. I'm gonna place an egg on this guy just to make sure I don't forget it. So now I at least score, I come in second place on that goal. So that was it. Now it is the Atoma, and he will draw a bird card. There is no bird that only wants to eat rodents, so he will take a face down. And there's that's it. Wow, he has so many points now. It's gonna be interesting to calculate later on. Okay, so now it is my my turn, and let's see, what do I do? Still need fish, but I think I'll do the egg action, because I won't get fish and be able to play them before the round is over. So I just realized that there's no way I can do. Well, if I trade. Oh yeah, if I trade. Okay, so let's do that then. So let's do this food thing again. So 3 food. And I'll just take. Now it doesn't matter because I'm going to trade, right? But if I don't have to trade, it's better. So let's take these 2. Like this. And then the 3rd I will reroll because now there's only 1 die face there. And there's the fish. Yeah. So then I. Oh, come on. Then I don't have to trade as much, which is good. Ah, there we go, a fish. There we go, okay. So that was that. Now we will activate everything again, which is fun. So this will double down, so let's do once again. No, let's double down on this one. So let's lay 2 eggs instead. Just because it's fun, these lovely eggs. And this one will tuck a card and so on. And draw another card. So there's a bunch of points under here. And I got the owl. Which, oh, this is drawing 2 new bonus cards and keep one. It's better that I play this guy then. Instead of playing the one down here. Huh, interesting. That's cheaper to play him. Okay, and then we activate this one to get a grain. And that's it for the row. Now it is the Atoma. And he will take some food, he will take all the rodents, there's none fish, yeah, okay, there's 1 fish, so I'll take that. And activate pink powers, there's no pink powers, I haven't played with those at all in this game. Just as it happened, as the, I didn't get any good cards to start off with that. But now, as my last action, I will play 2 eggs to go up there. And play this spotted owl. And he needs 2 rodents, I only have 1, but I can just pay any 2 others. As a replacement, and then when played, draw 2 new bonus cards and choose 1. I hope that I get something that just gives me points then for the end game. So it's either birds with color in their names, do I have that? No, I don't really have any with colors in their names. Or birds worth less than 4 points. Ooh, I do have that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wow, this is 6 points. Nice. That was the 6 point action to just draw that. Wow, that was nice. Okay, so that was my last action for the game. Now it is the Otomo's last action, and he will... Yeah, once again, he will get one face down. So that's 4 more points for him. And he will remove a cube. It doesn't matter. Now at the end here, he will score. He will beat me once again. I will be in second place. And now I guess we'll just do some calculations. So I'll pull out the little block here that we can write on. And let's just go through it step by step. And I think what... I mean, I don't want to win the first time I do this on camera, because I've only done it once before off camera, because that would be boring. I mean, it should be a challenge, right? And I'm going to lose. So here we have Niramas. And we have the Otomo. And let's see, Birch. Okay, so he has... he gets 3 points for this, and then for every face down he gets 4. So he has, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 43 points, congratulations to the Otomo. I have 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 14, 18, 19, 22, 30. Okay, I wasn't that far behind anyway. I had 1 8-pointer there. Then we have a bonus card. Well, I get 6 points for this. And for this, that... Oh, I'm stupid. I forgot about this. I should have more birch with an egg laid on them. Let's say I just did that then. Yeah, I should have made sure that they all have eggs on them. Because... No, now I don't even have 7. Oh, that's stupid. I forgot about this card, to be honest. I was so... Yeah, so much to consider. So, no, nothing there. And he doesn't get points for his bonus card. And round goals, he gets... let's see here. He gets... What is it? 4 on everything? No. So there's 4. So he gets 4, 9, 15, 22. I get 4. No, we actually split this. Yeah, okay, yeah. It's the same because we split it and then, yeah. So I get 2, 5, 9, 13. And then we have eggs. I have 5. He has 4, 8... 3, 6, 9, 10. He has 15. Food, I win, at least. Because I have 2, 4, 7. He doesn't have any food. And tucked cards, he doesn't have that. But I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that's 6 points. So I have 43, 50, 61 in score. He has 65, 70, 80. Okay, so I did lose pretty big, 61 to 80, but I had fun. And I think that if I keep playing this and getting better at it, I can beat that guy. Maybe I should have started on easy, I don't know. If I had, he would have had 3 points instead of 4 for each of these. So he would have had 10 points less, which means I still would have lost 61 to 70. But yeah, that is Wingspan Solo, and yeah. Just such a fun game. I'm gonna keep playing this both solo and with friends. Just love it. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great evening, morning, whenever you're watching. Take care. Bye bye.
Do you want to keep this little dragon this happy all day long? Then like the video. Board Games with Niramas is sponsored by Alara Games in Sweden.